Here, we'll look at the two-cell model of follicular estrogen secretion. Now, it's important to note when and where this is actually occurring. The follicular estrogen secretion actually only occurs during the ovarian cycle, initiated about once per 28 days. Now, recall that full folliculogenesis from primordial follicles takes nearly a year. And so we're basically jumping into the very end of a cycle here with antral secondary follicles that enter that ovarian or menstrual cycle to culminate in ovulation about 14 days into that cycle. Now, anatomically, we've got our oocyte over here on the right, the egg, surrounded by the layers of granulosa cells in purple here. There would be multiple layers of those at this phase, at antral secondary follicles. And then outside of that, in blue here, we have our theca cells, again, multiple layers. And the granulosa cells are the nurse cells. You can see they're actually linked to each other and to the egg itself via gap junctions. This allows for that coordinated control and development of that oocyte. And now we can look at, we've got this adjacent capillary over here, so we can look at the control of hormonal production by this developing antral secondary follicle during that follicular phase of the menstrual cycle, specifically the ovarian cycle. And so, of course, we're going to be looking at FSH and LH. And recall that these are the hormones that are going to be stimulating only these antral secondary follicles. They're not really active on follicles in earlier stages of development. If they were, then we'd be actually promoting the development of many, many more follicles. At this stage, we're down to a handful of follicles, secondary follicles, that are going to enter this follicular phase and result in ovulation of hopefully a single oocyte within that particular cycle. Now, the granulosa cells are the nurse cells, although they are going to help with the hormonal production here. The theca cells are the dominant secretory cells. They're going to respond to LH. And remember, the theca cells are going to be analogous to the Leydig cells in males that produce testosterone. And so similarly, we see the LH binding to receptors and initiating steroidogenesis here, the transition from cholesterol all the way down to an androgen known as androstenedione. That will be taken up by the granulosa cells across the basement membrane here and actually converted to estrogens. Now, to do so requires the FSH, as FSH is going to act on those granulosa cell receptors shown here and increase aromatase expression. Aromatase, of course, is that enzyme that converts androgens to estrogens, right? So here we have it acting on that androstenedione, generating estrogens, which will then, of course, be taken back up into the bloodstream. Now, in addition, we're also going to get a hormone called inhibin B that gets enhanced as well in response to FSH. And overall, the inhibin and the estrogen are going to be the dominant hormones in that follicular phase. They're acting on the uterus to initiate changes there, but they're also feeding back negatively on the FSH secretion. That sounds a little bit counterintuitive. FSH is the hormone that's sort of initiating the development of this follicle and the estrogen secretion in the first place. But what we want is to reduce our FSH stimulation of other follicles such that only the most FSH-sensitive follicle will go to full development and ovulate its oocyte and result in potential fertilization.